Welcome back, everybody. Back down. I'm on the old club water again now with my son. And it's only a 2-rod water at the moment, so I've got my rods out, my Teriernes. I've got some nice Teriernes. New ones, got 3, but you're only allowed 2. My boy's down in the bivvy there. There's his little rod there, teaching him how to fish this weekend. I'm here in my Super Brolly. Ready to go. Talk through the rigs and that later and what I'm doing, but yeah, it's good to be back, guys. Happy days. Really looking forward to this trip. Okay, so the planner action is on the right hand rod, going 8.5 wraps, 10 foot of water onto a small gravel area. We're doing a tiger nut with a little bit of tiger nut stick, and on the right hand rod basically, because it's only 2 rods, we're using a Nash 20mm, bit of a big one, white chocolate, and on that we're also using a nutty mix. But in a couple of these with a nutty mix, we've got some chopped up Nash as well in there, so that's the plan, that's what we're doing. And hopefully we'll get something. Now they've just finished spawning because the lakes have just reopened again, and it'll be cool. Down here with my boy who's baiting up for me. There he is there.
Hi.
Just teaching you how to fish, haven't we, son?
Mm-hmm.
Cool. So everything's ready for tonight and that. Let's see what we can get. Well, I am gutted. I've been here about an hour and a half on the 20mm Nash of all size baits. Just had a screaming run, hooked into it, took loads of line. And then look what happened. Absolutely gutted. Hook come right off the rig. That's one of them Ronnie rigs. Absolutely gutted. Wow, gutted. Pulled straight through. That's the quarter crimp, look. Good old quarter crimp yet again. Let me down. They keep on doing that, to be fair. That's it, I'm done with them. Absolutely done. Done. I am wounded. Okay. So now my boy's fishing. Nasty's got his stuff out. I'm going to get him a couple of 10-foot rods for his birthday, I think. Get rid of that one. It's definitely no good for carp. All right for like bleak and little perch, but that's about it. Oh, he's fishing away there, look. And the old quarter stows. Cool beans. And there's me on the Fox Black Label compact pod, which, to be fair, guys, is an absolutely cracking bit of kit, to be honest. Really is worth the money. It's a really good little pod. I like it a lot. So they're worth the your hard earned, to be fair. That's a good pod. I recommend it. Yeah, he's fishing away. Hopefully he's gonna get some. I'm still proper fuming with them quarter crimps. Tell ya, that was crimped right down as well on the boom. It should have held, but pulled at the hook end, so not impressed at all. But we'll see. Boy's just gone for a wander. He's closed up his bivvy, just gone for a little wander. Bless him. Around the lake. We've got the walkie-talkie so I can hear him. Yeah, all set up ready hopefully tonight. Got the light ready for the camera. Everything ready to rock and roll, guys. Hopefully the night will bring some nice fishes. Okay, guys, it's getting on for the evening now. So we're going to get the rods repositioned back out on the spots. Both of them now are doing 12.5 wraps on that gravel where I had to run. Still both on a white Nash 20mm chocolate. One's got a bit of cork in it, the old Muzzle rig. So I'm going to give that a go, and one's just lying flat on the bottom. So hopefully we'll get one in. My boy's finished for the day. He was fishing for a bit, but he's done. Going to get my 2-rod set up next month, so that'll be nice. Just watching the water. If I see any movement on the top, I shall get out a zig, obviously, like you do. But yeah, hopefully the next one will be a fish on the bank and not the morning blog. Happy days.
okay, guys. Unfortunately, nothing last night apart from a rough sleep. And this morning, I reeled in one of the rods to rebait, and my arthritis on my thumb is making it very difficult to wind in. So I'm going to take some painkillers. Hopefully, that'll sort it. If not, unfortunately, it'll be at home time. So I'm even more gutted now about losing that fish yesterday, because it could end up being a blank, which would be very gutting. But I'm going to get both these rods back out, and I'm not going to be able to bait up those. No way I'm going to be able to spawn out any bait with that or catapult. So yeah, or throwing stick. Hopefully the painkillers will kick in and we'll be able to use the hand, but if not, like I said, be time to go. That's the biggest problem I've got, guys, is my arthritis. Makes fishing really difficult, painful. So we'll soldier on, see what we can do. Wish me luck.
Okay, guys, as you can see, the old bivouage is in a bit of a mess because I've been making the old ziggies. There we go. I've got a 9-foot zig out on the left-hand rod, and the right-hand rod we've got a bottom bait back on. So yeah, we shall see how we go. The painkillers have kicked in, the hand seems to be a bit better now, so all good. Yeah, got the zig out. Here we go, happy days. Hopefully 9-foot zig, 10-foot water, so we'll see how we get on. Cool beans.
Okay, guys, so I've just adjusted me a zig to, still got a bottom bait on, but I'm thinking about going on a zig on that of about 6-foot, but I've just adjusted the other zig from 9 down to 8.5, just 0.5 foot. See how that goes with a black bit on it, but like I said, I might put on sort of a 6 or 7 foot zig on the left hand rod, and because it's so hot today, it's ridiculously hot, and put on maybe a yellow or red or white bit, something like that. See if I can tempt him with something like that. So it's worth a go, so let's try it. Okay, so the left hand rod now, right hand rod, sorry, I apologise, is in the margin. I just took some advice from the bailiff. He said they haven't pushed out yet, so I'm in the margin, and the left hand rod is still on the zig. And that was a big crash there from a pike chasing some fish, so they're active. So yeah, we'll see what comes of it. It's 5:30 in the afternoon, early evening, so we've got a while of daylight left. And then I'll decide whether to put a second rod in the margin or keep it on the zig. I'm undecided at the moment, I'm not sure. So there's been a bit of activity on the surface, but not as much as there was yesterday. But we shall see what's evening.
It's 7 o'clock in the evening on the second night. Still time, I'm going to about 12 tomorrow. I'll try and beat the rain. Back down again Tuesday, so not long. By the time this is uploaded Monday, I'll be down the next day. I've tried a 6-foot zig, 7-foot zig, 8-foot and 9-foot zig in 10-foot of water, no show, 3 different colours, black, white and yellow, scented and unscented. So now I'm back on 12.5 wraps on the gravel bar on a 20mm Nash bait with a stick mix, and on the right hand rod I'm in the margin now, about 15 foot out from the bank, and I baited that up with some 16mm crab. So we're going to give that a go this evening, see what's what. My boy has been fishing all day, hasn't had anything, bless him, not even a tench, which should have been nice for him to get a bend in the rod, obviously, on his first trip. He doesn't like his rod anyway, so he's asked for 2 new ones, so I'll be getting him 2 new rods next week. The Witchwood rods, either a 9 or 10 pound foot, sorry, in a 2¾ test curve. That's what he's asked for. I've heard they're good rods, so happy days. Yeah, so it's still time. I'm still trying, that's the main thing. Every trip is an adventure and a learning curve. So we'll see what we take away from this one. But happy days. After losing that one yesterday with the hook pulling off from the quarter crimp, I have gone back to what I used to do and what I should have done in the first place, and that is the little tag end bit on the end of the crimps. What I do is hopefully in this light you'll be able to see it. What I've been doing is now, and I forgot to do it basically, is each little end has a little tag. Well, what it does is I just blobs that off, and that before used to stop it, and I forgot to do it like I did low. See there, a little tag end, hope you can see that. Just blob that off, and even if it pulls, that is enough to stop it, and it can't pull all the way through. Because what happened was it pulled off, I took a picture of it, put it on my Instagram, through there, and I lost the hook. So that's how that fish got away. But now, just lobbing it off. There we go, there it is, little blobblet. Just blob off the end, and that stops the crimp from pulling through if it pulls through. So that's what I've done, and that's always worked in the past. So there's a top tip for you guys, just blob off the end, and it'll stop them from slipping through. Happy day, that. No lead left on there. Here's the old bait, that. Oh, there's only a little, and we ain't going to bother weighing them. Dumpy Simo, he's only a baby, like I said, he's very welcome, forgive me for that then, he's got to be 7-8 pound, isn't he? He's a little one, but he'll do, he'll do. Like a seal. Like that. Put a bit of water on it. Looks like a waxy seal. It's really good actually. Just checking for marks. There you go. Sure his fins are back. Let's get him back. Okay guys, that's 7 in the morning. Oh, excuse me. And yeah, after that carp, 2 bream, 1 in the margin and 1 back over there. So I've decided to put the right hand rod now back on a 9-foot zig. See how that goes. Just as an added boost, I'd put a little bit of this on it. This is the super sweet zig liquid by Mainline. There it is there. So I put some of that on it. And see how that goes, because I saw a couple on the surface just not jumping but just like mouth out giving it the old munchy. So I decided put the zig back on for a couple of hours, see what's what. I'm going to go about 12 ish, so we've still got time hopefully for another, and go from there. Okay guys, the one rod left, going in about an hour, just before the rain. It's already tried once, which is basically one of the landing nets already packed up, most of the other stuff's already in the car, little man over there. So yeah, back down Tuesday, Sunday today, so not long, for another go at it. Hopefully get something better, bigger, sorry, not better, bigger. Carp's a carp. So yeah, it was nice to have a carp on my new rod, see what they were like. And I heard from a reliable source that there's three ghosties in here. I wouldn't mind targeting them, to be honest with you guys, because I do like ghosties a lot. And koi's, so we'll see. We'll see. They get down the other end, so I will be doing down there at some point and going for them, especially them. See if I can find them and target them. Be nice, because I never even knew they was in here, but then I never looked. But yeah, basically, that's probably it, unless I sneak one out. If not, I'll see you on the next one. Hope you like. Subscribe if you like. Hit the thumbs up if you like it, and the thumbs down if you don't. And put in the comments, why not? And I'll see if I can change anything about the blogs. Till next time, guys. Have a good one. Tight lines.